Hey guys, welcome.
Hold on, now talk.
Hey guys, welcome. This is the brand new show. I'm Will Hornblad. This is the Midday Show with Will and Sophia. Says it so back there. I don't know if you can really see it all that well. But yeah, I'll just be hosting today. Unfortunately, Sophia just had to step out. I believe she's on vacation. Come back soon, Sophia. Okay, so this is the ninth brand new show that the Advanced Live TV Broadcasting class has put up. This class was started by a senior by the name of Charlie Werke, and the name of the first show was called The Midday Show with Charlie Werke. Now producers Megan Self and Andy Stinson, as well as director Tyler DeWard, bring you our brand new show. If you remember back to last year at this exact same time, we had one by the name of Lights Out Tonight. But then we were forced into distance learning because of COVID. Through the years, students have been able to do a variety of things on this show, and we've even had Mr. Lund, our assistant principal, perform along with the FHS Jazz Band. We are beyond excited to be able to bring you in this awesome studio and bring you a variety of fun this trimester. So, with that said, stay tuned.
Live from Farmington High School in Farmington, Minnesota, it's the Midday Show with Will and Sophia, featuring Sophia Tarood, Will Hornblad, Allison Hoffman, Andy Stinson, Frank Mooney, Nick Simon, Megan Self, Tyler DeWard, Brighton Sheehan, Dane Veckert, Lyle Hoffmeister, Mr. Mathis, and Mr. Tauchi. And now, here's your hosts, Will Hornblad and Sophia Tarood.
So guys, welcome back. I hope you really liked our intro. I really liked putting it together. We had a whole lot of fun putting it together. So before we get started with anything, I think it's just kind of important that we at least kind of keep up the heritage of Tiger News this trimester and just run through some current world events. So if you live in Australia, I'm sure you're aware of all the various living dangerous human hazards that live around you. And that's only going to get more fun for people down under right around this year. So amid some seasonal flooding, herds of snakes and spiders and other just crawlies and slithering things have flocked to people's porches, decks, and homes in order to evade the water. So just like imagine going out in the morning to get a nice fresh breath of air to just see your ground covered by snakes. That'd be so gross. And anyways, you know, kind of moving on, moving a little bit more eastern in terms of Australia, Kazakhstan has launched the first effort to clean up decommissioned and presently unused space satellites and probes. You know, we're kind of avoiding that future we saw in WALL-E where he went out of orbit and he saw all those like really old satellites and space junk. You know, anything to avoid that. And if you made a bracket for March Madness, you must be punching yourself at least a little bit right now, as there have been many upsets. More recently, Ohio and Florida's losses to the unexpected success of Oral Roberts, and our very own director Tyler DeWard was just recently disappointed by Iowa's loss to Oregon. Don't get that confused with Iowa State. He does not like that. So, with all that said, we're going to bring you our next segment. It's arguably my favorite. Frank and Nick worked really hard on it. Let's roll Simon Search.
We're tuning in. This is the first episode of Simon Search. All right, we're here with the Midday Show. What's your name?
Destiny and Madison.
And if animals could talk, which one would be the most boring?
Probably sloth.
Sloth? I'd say something like a snail. They don't make too much noise, you know, so. All right, we found someone in the hall. What do you think about pineapple on pizza?
That is a hard no.
Hard no?
That should not be legal.
Yeah.
Pineapple on pizza is delicious.
We got a mixed response there. You know, I work at Domino's personally, so we get a lot of pineapple orders, but I'd say no. What is your name?
Charlie Darrow.
If you could be a fictional character, what would it be?
A bird so I can fly.
That's not fictional, but all right, thank you.
Hey, would you like to be interviewed for the Midday Show?
No.
All right, we have Mr. Hooper here, and when do you think Thomas Jefferson was born?
Columbus sailed the ocean blue 1479, divided in half 250, 16. Carry the 1739.
I think that might be correct. So how many months are in a day?
I'd say 30. If you're talking months,
365 divided by 4? I'd say final answer 60.
No. How many chickens do you think it takes to kill an elephant?
200.
It's a good response. You know, I'd probably go with around like 1,000 maybe, but yep, we'll find another person to ask another question. Would your only mode of transportation be a donkey or a giraffe?
Donkey.
Donkey? For sure. Yeah, I'd probably go with that too. I mean, it'd be easy to saddle up, you know, and mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're reliable.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. All right, thank you. Thanks for watching. Tune in next week for more.
All right, so that was Simon's Search. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I really did. And now we're joined in the studio with one of FHS's brand new teachers, Ms. Hemmingway. Ms. Hemmingway, welcome to the studio. Hope you're having a good time. So obviously we're going to do sort of an interview thing, like a late night show, and I guess we'll just get right into it. So what have you liked most about being at FHS so far?
Yeah, and I'll stop you really quick. My name is Mrs. Hemmingsen. It's nice. No, it's okay. It's really nice because I'm an English teacher,
yeah.
And Hemmingway just really fits. So,
yeah.
So can you repeat your question?
So what have you liked most about being at FHS so far?
Oh, I have loved the staff I get to work with. I'm on the 9th grade English team and really just enjoying learning from each other and collaborating, things like that. But I got to say my favorite part of being at FHS is the students. We've really kind of battled through some things this trimester and still kind of done some learning and reflecting and really getting better this year, so.
Yeah, absolutely. So, this is kind of just bouncing off of what we established there. What would be your favorite part of your job so far here at FHS?
Oh gosh, my favorite part of my job at FHS, I think the one constant that we have kind of gotten to enjoy this year is TC time.
Yeah.
And this is my first time having an advisory period and knowing that I get to stick with these kids for the next 4 years of their lives and kind of connecting with them and watching them grow and change and kind of helping them along. That's definitely kind of my favorite part this year.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's say you could travel anywhere in the world. What would be like your favorite place to travel to? It could be somewhere you've been, somewhere you want to go. Where would it be?
Yeah. In a post-COVID world,
yeah.
I would love to travel to the Greek islands. Somewhere I haven't been.
Yeah.
You know, there's some beach, there's some culture, a little bit of everything.
Yeah. So, what kind of places have you traveled to? And, you said you wanted to go to the Greek islands, but where would be kind of, like, let's say you go to the Greek islands, where would be next? So, places you've been, places you want to go.
Sure. Some places I have been able to travel to, I got to spend some time in China. One of my dear friends, growing up, her parents were from there, and they were they emigrated to the United States when we were really little, and so I got to stay with her family up in the mountains in a very remote area of China, as well as some time in Shanghai. I had some flashbacks on like Facebook. I know,
yeah.
Mentioning Facebook dates me a little bit, but I
no,
got to spend some time in Ireland. Where else have I been? I got to spend some time in Alaska. Yeah, I do really like to travel and learn new things from everywhere I go.
For sure. And I guess this is just kind of wrapping up our interview here. What made you want to become a teacher? What was sort of that clicking point that you realized this is what I want to do?
Yeah, sure. So both of my parents are lifelong educators. They both taught fifth grade, and I really got to see kind of the ins and the outs of what it means to impact a student's life. And really kind of invest in a community. So they definitely inspired me, as well as many teachers that I had in high school, and kind of put me on this track. So
yeah. So thank you, Ms. Hemmingsen. We really appreciate you coming on down and doing that interview. And now in the studio, we're joined with our very own Mr. Tauchi, and we're going to be running through some reverse taboo.
Hey, Mr. Tauchi, I am filling in today for Lyle Hoffmeister. He was a He's going to be doing some segments with you guys this trimester, and we've got this really cool game called Taboo. But you know what? We thought I'm going to ask the audio, Megan, our audio person, to turn up Will's microphone. And Will, how's it going over there?
It's going pretty great. I'm having a whole lot of fun with this show so far, and hopefully we can sort of just keep this train on rolling.
Awesome. Okay, so you ready for reverse taboo?
I am. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to list off 5 words. And you are going to tell me what the word, the main word is, all
yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
My son Lucas thought this would be kind of a cool thing to do. Okay, so leafy.
Okay.
Vegetable.
All right.
Eat. Green. Popeye.
Cabbage.
Spinach. All right. Number two, any, one, none, nothing, number.
Zero?
Zero is correct, very good. Oh, all right,
here we go.
Next one. I'm gonna give you a hint right now. This should never be on a pizza.
Oh.
Fruit, Hawaii, juice, upside down cake, dole.
Pineapples.
Very good, all right.
Awesome.
Last one, date, hour, time, in and home. Date, hour, time, in and home.
Calendar maybe? I don't know.
Curfew,
ooh. I was way off on that one.
All right, we're gonna take a look at our weather forecast here. Today we're gonna have some rain showers. It's already raining, but a high of 44. Thursday is gonna be partly sunny. Yeah, right. Hopefully we get rid of some of this rain because, well, the rain is helping like the football field. Not that the football field has any grass, duh. It doesn't, it's got turf, right? Brand new turf. All right, so Thursday, partly sunny. And Friday is also going to be mostly sunny. Both days are going to be a high of 49 degrees. What I meant to say, Mr. Graff, if you're watching, your baseball field and Mr. Winters, just think of how green your grass is becoming with the precipitation and it's raining down. So, all right. Anyway, Will, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Tauchi. It's always a treat having him on this show. So, with that said, we're going to throw it to a new segment. This is sort of, you know, just all new segments, all new show. This one's probably for more of our foodie people. This one is called Culinary Expeditions.
Hello, Farmington. My name is Andy, and welcome to Culinary Expeditions. And this is going to be a show where I teach you how to make health meals that are really cheap to make, also really easy to make. And for this first episode, we're going to be making steak. And you're going to ask, hey, isn't steak expensive? Well, normally it is, but I found some ways to make it really cheap to make, as well as super easy to make. We're gonna be making a steak along with just a little simple salad on the side. So let's go.
Okay, so we're gonna get started out by melting some garlic butter here in the microwave. These little garlic butter chips you can get for, I believe, 50 cents each over at Hy-Vee. You can get them at the meat department counter. And we're gonna get those we're not gonna get it completely melted, just softened up a little bit. And then you're gonna wanna grab a pan, preferably cast iron, and get your stove set to the high setting. Once you got that taken care of, we're gonna start getting our steaks prepped. You're just going to take all your garlic butter and get that spread on the top half of the steak. And these are actually some ribeye steaks that we got on sale for Hy-Vee for, I believe, $6 each. There were some cheaper options there, but either they wouldn't really make the best steak or they just straight up didn't have it in stock. However, you don't need exactly the most fancy cut of meat to make a great steak. Now, once you get all your butter spread on there, you're going to start seasoning your steaks with some salt and pepper. And then we're going to be on to our next step, which is just getting them on the pan. You're going to want to lay those on there very carefully, butter side down, to get those started. And to get these cooked, if you want rare, you're going to want to go about 2.5 minutes aside, medium rare, 3 minutes aside, medium right about 4 minutes aside, medium well, right about 4 to 4.5. And frankly, if you like well-done steak, you are a menace to society. I'm not even going to tell you how long to cook it for. Use context clues. Now that you got your steaks on there, you're going to want to start getting your garlic butter spread on there and make absolutely sure to burn yourself. Just like that. After you recover from your burn injuries, make sure you get your salt and pepper put on the other side of the steak. Once you've cooked the bottom half of your steak to the appropriate doneness, you're going to want to take a pair of tongs, get it gently flipped over, and get it cooked for the same amount of time as you did the other side. When the time has elapsed, just give a double check on both sides of the steak just to make sure they're cooked evenly, and you want to get those removed onto a plate where they're going to rest for about 4 to 5 minutes, which in the meantime, that's when we'll be making our salad to go along with the steaks. So this salad's gonna be incredibly simple. We're first gonna start out with some chopped up green and red bell peppers, and then we're gonna add a little bit of shredded carrots. And after that, we're gonna be adding some baby spinach to our salad. As for dressing, we're keeping it incredibly simple here. After you get your dressing added, you're gonna start tossing your salad, and you're gonna realize that I should have maybe grabbed a bigger bowl, and I'm gonna start making a mess everywhere, but don't worry, that's important. It adds a lot to the flavor. Now that your salad's done, you're gonna start plating up your food by first placing your steak on one side of the plate and then your salad on the other side of the plate. And altogether, this actually came out a lot cheaper than you might expect. Altogether, this costed less than $20, and that's for two whole plates of food, as opposed to when you go to a restaurant, you're eating steak dinner for two, you're gonna be spending, without even the tip, that's gonna be at least like $25 to $30 for two people. And with tips and sales tax, you're looking at well over $30.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of Culinary Expeditions. Next week, I've got some vegetarian recipes for all you vegan and vegetarian homies at home. And back to the desk.
All right, so thank you, Andy. It turned out really great. The steak looked awesome. Hope you enjoyed it. So in the studio today, we're joined by our second group of interviewers. This is, of course, the people for the play. This year, the Farmington Play production team is putting on 12 Angry Jurors. It'll be performed this Friday and Saturday at 7 p.m. at Bachman Middle School Theater. So thank you guys for coming down. We really appreciate it. Really appreciate you guys taking the time out of your day to do this. So I guess we'll just start off by, what are your names and what are your roles?
I'm Carson, and I'm the stage manager, and I play the guard.
I'm Kylie. I play juror number 8. Gotcha.
I'm Brighton, and I play juror number 3.
Awesome. So could you guys maybe just like inform me and the people at home about what this show is about?
Yeah. 12 Angry Jurors follows the jury deliberations after a murder trial, and it's a great show in which we see kind of the background of what a verdict takes. It's all about humanity and working together.
For sure, for sure. Like a lot of just sort of, you know, selfless and, you know, questioning of ideals. So what would you say is your favorite part of the play?
I really love that I got to create my own character. In the original production, my character was a man, so it was really great to be able to make my own background and really start her from scratch.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed, we have some thunder sound effects at the end, and I got to design where those go, so it makes the tone of the second act a lot more grim.
Without revealing too much of the play here, I just like yelling at her. It's so much fun.
Yeah. Yeah, no, obviously. And you guys are all seniors, so, you know, this is sort of your last year at FHS. This is your swan song. What are you guys going to miss most about FHS theater?
I think I'm really going to miss my people. It's really like having a play date with your best friends every day. Like, these are my favorite people, and I love hanging out with them.
For sure, the people. I can't add to that. I mean.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's so much fun to just hang out with your friends every day. Because, like, especially with the plays, it's just such a small cast that, like, everyone really gets to know each other and you just become best friends by the end of it.
Yeah, so obviously thank you guys for, you know, coming down to the studio, answering these questions. I hope the play, you know, does really well. You guys seem like you're going to have a lot of fun with it. And we really just appreciate you guys taking the time down to come on down and do it. So now we're just kind of going to hang out for a little bit, just you guys and me and the host and you guys in the audience. So, you know, this is a brand new show. We've kind of had a whole lot of fun putting it together this trimester. You know, there's been some bumps, but I think we really got it going. So, now I'm joined in the studio again by Mr. Tauchi. Mr. Tauchi, what do you got for us?
All right, so I'm back. This is another Lyle Hoffmeister segment, but I'm filling in for him today. We are doing, I should have known that, and back in, during the holidays, I don't know if anybody knows Morgan Bombach, but we did a Secret Santa back in the day in December. Morgan Bombach gave me this game called I Should Have Known That. It's a pretty cool game. It's got some trivia things. So, Will, you have your mic on?
I do have my mic on, yeah.
All right, I'm going to throw you some questions here.
All right.
I'm going to be super sad if you don't get this first one, okay?
Okay.
Okay. What publishing company created superheroes like Iron Man and Captain America?
That has to be Marvel, right? Marvel Comics.
Marvel Comics, yes. Perfect. Ding, ding, ding. Megan, give us that. All right. Here's a good one. What company released the game console Wii?
That would be Nintendo, right?
Yes. Add another 3 points. Perfect. All right. How often do you use a computer?
Well, I don't know. I don't really use a computer whole often, but if you count an iPad as a computer, I'd say I at least use it 10 times a day, and those times could span anywhere from like an hour to, you know,
okay,
a couple hours just doing work or whatever.
Got it. Okay, so this one's going to be a little bit more challenging for you, okay?
Yeah.
What happens if you select text and press Control plus C on your keyboard?
Is that copy?
It is. Text is copied. Ding, ding, ding. Yes. All right. And the last question I have. You like $100 bills?
Yeah, you know, I like money.
I do too.
Yeah.
I have none right now.
Oh.
Who appears on the American $100 bill?
That'd have to be one of our founding fathers, Ben Franklin, right?
It is. Very good. You did really well with that, Will.
Thank you. Nice job.
All right, so for Lyle Hoffmeister, hopefully he'll be back next week. I'm Mr. Tauchi, back to Will at the desk.
All right, so that was sort of, you know, Lyle's second segment. We're really excited for him to be a part of the show. He just couldn't make it today. We're really sad about it, but Lyle, we look forward to seeing you next week. So, you know, we're kind of wrapping it up. We're approaching the end, but don't worry. We have some really cool stuff coming up for you. We have another, these are more of like two comedic segments. I really like them. We got Cat Chat and Cube Corner. Let's roll it, guys.
Oh, wait. Hello, everybody. My name is Megan, and this is Sammy and Enoki, and this is Cat Chat. Normally, we would be accompanied by one Brighton Sheehan, but he's at theater right now. So I got some catnip here.
Give.
Ooh. It's a hassle to deal with cats. They're like little children, and he hurt my finger. So we got my boys here. Gave him some catnip. What catnip does is it targets, I guess, the happy receptors in their brain, but it has effects, different effects on different cats. For instance, Enoki is younger, so he's gonna be more hyper on it. Cat ASMR. Yeah, so today we're gonna be asking them some questions. Unless I get beat up by Enoki because he's looking at me with murder in his eyes. Ooh. Can you please stop biting at the catnip for 2 seconds so we can continue with the interview? You realize that this catnip comes at a price, right?
I do not care. Give me more of the catnip.
Really? You're gonna be like that about it? He's literally rolling in catnip. Hey, buddy. How you doing today?
Put me down, you foul baby.
Yeah, okay. Let me ask you, what's your favorite color?
I can only see blue. What a rude question, you insolent beast.
Oh, okay. Okay, now, what is your favorite thing to eat besides catnip, obviously?
Give me your arm. I require sustenance.
I guess it's me. You're not being a good showman. Can you let go of me?
Give!
I know he likes ham. Ham?
Ham.
Do you want some after this interview?
I require ham.
If you stop being a nuisance, maybe you will. Maybe you will get some. That was chaotic. This has been Megan with Cat Chat. Don't get cats. Because...
Ah!
They will do this. Let go of the windscreen, please.
No!
Sam.
No!
Sam.
Now it's time for Brighton's segment, Cube Corner. Bye!
Hey, my name is Brighton. This series is taking so long that it actually had to go into the third try, and welcome back to another episode of... Seriously, you'd probably be better off just looking up a YouTube tutorial. This is a terrible way to teach people how to solve Rubik's Cubes. In the last episode, I taught you guys how to solve the middle layer, so now we're on to the last, or yellow, layer. Now, to solve the last layer, you're going to need these things called algorithms. Scary, I know. Every time I talk about algorithms, everyone always thinks of math, which is reasonable. Algorithms are used in math, but what an algorithm is just a set of moves. But they look like this. Yeah. So this random string of letters isn't mumbo jumbo, it's actually a set of moves. Each letter corresponds to a move that you have to do. Now, in future episodes, I'm probably just going to explain algorithms in the sense of move the top to the left. However, if that's not how you like to learn, or if that gets to be too confusing, I will have the algorithm showing on the screen in all of its jumbled glory for you to pause and look over. But first, you have to understand what each letter means. So let's go over that. So the letters are as follows. R, L, U, D, F, B, and M. R means you're going to take the right side of the cube and rotate it clockwise. L means you're going to take the left side of the cube and rotate it clockwise. U means you're going to take the top or up side of the cube and rotate it clockwise. B means you're going to take the back side of the cube and rotate it clockwise. F means you're going to take the front side of the cube and rotate it clockwise. I'm sounding like a broken record here. B means you're going to take the bottom of the cube and rotate it clockwise. And finally, M means you're going to take the middle slice of the cube and rotate it clockwise. Now, along with these letters, there is a modifier called prime. It's basically just an apostrophe. So if you see R apostrophe, you're going to take the right side of the cube and rotate it counterclockwise. Same with everything else. I'm not going to go through it again. Right and left in an algorithm aren't going to be turning the same way. So if I saw R in an algorithm, I'd take the right side and I'd turn it clockwise. But if I saw L in an algorithm, I'd still turn it clockwise to this face, but it would be turning a different way from my point of view. You can see we have white and yellow. If that doesn't make sense, I can't really find a better way to explain it. Again, look up a tutorial. This is a terrible way to teach people how to solve a Rubik's Cube. I'm mainly doing this because Mr. Tauchi really wants to learn how to solve a Rubik's Cube, and who am I to say no to Mr. Tauchi? You try. That was stupid. That's your terrible crash course on algorithms. Hopefully it'll make more sense in future videos when we actually start applying this to actual algorithms. But that's going to be it for this episode. So I will see you next week.
All right, guys. So, when we had the teacher in here, we forgot to do a little putting here right here. But I'm going to do it. I'm going to make up for it. Don't you guys worry. You'll get your fill of Will trying to attempt at golf, a sport he was never good at or has rarely ever played before. So, I'm lining up my shot. I see it right there. This isn't really even a real hole, but I'm going to still try and sink it. Lord only knows if I'll make it. Here we go. All right. All right. Ah, so close. Too hard. Oh, yeah, I know. Believe me, I know, guys. I'm blaming myself, too. I'm going to get back to my desk with my cool Kool-Aid Man Funko Pop. Ugh. Alrighty. So that's kind of it for the show. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I really had a lot of fun, hosting it and making you guys, trying to include the audience, you guys, as much as possible. Had a whole lot of fun having the theater kids come down here, that really awesome teacher. Stop by her room, check her out. She seems really lovely. And that's kind of all we got for the show today. I'm Will Hornblad. This is the Will and Sophia Show, the Midday Show with Will and Sophia. Have a great Tiger Day.
By yon bonny banks and by yon bonny braes, where the sun shines bright on Loch Lomond, where me and me true love were ever wont to gay, on the bonny, bonny banks o' Loch Lomond. sing and the wild flowers spring, and in sunshine the waters lie sleeping. But the